Well, the holidays are practically here. Thanksgiving is right around the corner. You've got family and friends coming over, and you want to make something delicious, but a little different.
Joining us today is Lisa DiFebo-OSIAS with DiFebo's Restaurant, which has two locations, one in Bethany Beach and one in Rehoboth Beach. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, and thanks for having me back.
This is awesome.
I love being here.
What are we making today?
We are going to utilize all those pumpkins that are all over your yards. So we're going to take a pumpkin from our front lawn, we're going to bake it, and we're going to turn it into a beautiful pumpkin cannelloni.
Ooh, sounds good. So what else do we need?
So we're going to start off with, I've already roasted your pumpkins, so we don't have to wait for that. So I'm going to give you two, both some jobs.
Tell us what's in here.
We have a little bit of roasted pumpkin, ricotta cheese, we have a bechamel, which is going to be our sauce. This is a secret cookie and crushed up, and we're going to use that. Some Parmesan cheese and mascarpone. And then to flavor it, we're going to do a little bit of amaretta, which is going to give us some sweetness. Marjoram, which is my grandmother's secret to her ravioli. And a little bit of sage, just to bring that whole fall together. And then we're going to finish it with some yummy stuff that, that you can help us. So Jimmy, if you want to start, why don't you start? We're going to make a cheese mixture. And what I said, we are going to make a pumpkin with ricotta, not ricotta with pumpkin.
Okay, gotcha.
So let's put in some, about three spoonfuls of your ricotta cheese.
I'm going to get this out of the way because I will knock it over.
I'll take
all of this stuff mine or some of this Lisa's?
Well, you know what? I'm going to give Lisa, this is going to be some finishing delicious finishing things. So you'll mix, and then when you're ready, we're going to roll.
Okay. So I have to wait on Jimmy before I can do my part.
Oh, now see, and isn't that just how it always is? All right, I'm going to put that right here.
But while we're waiting on Jimmy, we can talk a little bit about the pumpkins, because you've got a little bit of variety here.
So yeah, as I said, we were driving in Sussex County. There's so many wonderful pumpkin stands, and I found a woman that gave me a little quick lesson on pumpkins. And she introduced me to this beautiful Hubbard pumpkin. And a Hubbard pumpkin inside is almost like a sweet potato. It's delicious. It's a little drier. And some of our friends in the area use those to make pumpkin pies. So we enjoy those with ravioli and things that you wanted something drier. So there's our, one of our secret ingredients.
You're not going to tell me more about the secret cookie?
No.
Man.
No.
Come on.
I went to Miami to learn that.
All right. We're
going to add a little bit. You did your mascarpone.
I got the mascarpone.
So let's add a little bit of our marjoram, a pinch of sage.
Our marjoram?
Which is right here, our dry marjoram.
Just, kind of
just a pinch.
Just a little.
Perfect.
Good, And then we're going with the sage.
And I'm going to show you something. So as you're, what you're doing right now is you're seasoning the ricotta cheese, right? When you add your pumpkin, we're going to re-season again a little bit more, okay?
Why? Why don't we do it all now?
That gives you like, because we're going to layer our flavors. Because you're going to get a good job and you're going to know that you're seasoning this well. That's separate. That's a whole nother baby. So let's add a little bit of, amaretta.
Amaretta.
If you're feeling like you need a little.
This is the ingredient.
Yep, there you go. Now I want you to mix this because we don't want to break that up. So we're going to mix all this first, and then we're going to fold in the pumpkin. Okay, because we want to keep those chunks in there.
Kind of like crab meat, lump crab
meat.
You never mix it, it in.
And you want to put it in the end. Yep, exactly right. And that's why we're putting that in the end. And we want to mix this thoroughly. You know, one of the things we were talking about, this dish is really delicious if you want to add sweet potatoes, if you want to omit the pumpkin and add crab. You can do, I love cooking where we can
flexible.
Make it very flexible.
Okay.
That looks wonderful. So now I want you to take two or three nice heaping spoonfuls of that and then just re-season it again for me. And just go back
the same
to
way as before?
We're going to add a little bit more cheese, a little bit of your secret cookie.
My secret cookie or your secret cookie? Yeah, it's her secret cookie.
Because if you say it's Jimmy's secret cookie, then everybody's going to be asking
him
it is.
All right, and then just a little bit of everything there. You can just
do this again, right?
That's the only thing I wouldn't do again.
Don't do that.
Just your cheese, your cookie, and your seasoning.
So the idea is, because we got to move along here, because I haven't done anything yet. So I'm going to you're going to basically mix that together, and then we're going to roll it up.
We are going to take this. Let's start that. So we have lasagna sheets that you can buy in the store. We make our own at the restaurant, which is lovely. And we are going to just put a little bit of this mixture on here. In the meantime, we're going to take a little bechamel, which is just this lovely cream sauce, and we're going to put it at the bottom.
Put it at the bottom of the pan.
Now fold that nice and gentle.
Everybody's calling me slow here.
Yeah.
You can. You can.
How's this for
I can
for
what?
Pick it up.
I can dance when
you
I'm...
Can.
What is it I'm supposed to be
do
doing
pick
here?
It up? Okay. That's perfect. That's okay. Beautiful. Yep.
All right.
Okay. So now we're going to just, I'm just going to give that one little along the side.
That would make it right.
Yeah. So Lisa, you can use this and I want you to just kind of right in the middle, just put it right here.
Okay. Okay. A little more? Or is
We want a little bit more than that.
A little bit more. Okay. Now these are in chunks. So.
Think that you're feeding me. That'll tell you how much to put it in.
How about just a little bit more?
Okay.
Okay. Beautiful.
There we go.
Let's just do one and I'll show you.
Okay. All right.
So what you want to do is now just kind of even that out and start rolling it, okay? And roll it lightly and kind of fold it. You don't have to roll it. That's
it.
That's beautiful.
Ah,
you did a nice job. You're going to lay it right in that bechamel.
Okay.
That's lovely.
Like that? Oops.
Yep. Now we're
going to
put a bunch of them in there.
Right.
When it's all done, we're going to put a little bechamel over it and we're going to flavor it. But
we have a finished one through the magic of TV.
We do.
Jimmy's going to pull it out right now.
Oh, thank you.
I'm going to grab a fork or two. And while he's getting that out of the oven, I'll let you know that you can get this recipe by sending us a self-addressed stamped envelope to 1729 North Salisbury Boulevard, Salisbury, Maryland, 21801. You can also go to our website, WBOC.com, click on our picture at the top of the page, or give us a call, 443-880-9116. Okay, we're not even going to let you plate it.
We're going straight in.
Going straight in.
Lisa, thank you so much for showing us.
You're welcome. Thank
fantastic.
You for having me here.
This is and it is hot, so we're going to...
It's hot.
Is it hot?
It smells so good.
It's very full. And then I put a little garnish of the pumpkin on top.
Right.
Which will help you. Mm. How is
that? That's nice. Good stuff.
That tastes like Thanksgiving.
Good.
Right
good
there. Lisa, that is so good.
Thank you. Thanks for having
much.
Me.
And after making a meal like this, the only thing that could make your day even better is hearing your name called in our holiday guide giveaway. We'll announce another winner next.
Delmarva Life, we'll be right back. Man, that's good.
Ooh. Do you like that? Ah.